This is the Ola S1 Pro, and we've seen this scooter in multiple reviews. We've done a couple of reviews of the scooter on the channel, but this has now got the most awaited MoveOS 3 update, and it comes with some really nice party tricks. For example, check this out. It now gets user customizable sounds. You can select from three sounds and a lot of other features. We're going to tell you all of the details and all the new changes on the Ola S1 Pro. So let's get started. Now, the sound that you heard was one of the modes of the Ola S1 Pro. And as a part of the Move 3.0 update, these are the modes that you get. This one right here is the vintage mode, and you get this nice retro dial right here, a retro style trip meter and a retro style odometer, along with your music controls, which have this nice retro style look, and you can switch the modes. Now let me turn the scooter on so that you can hear what this mood sounds like. So every mood has a sound as well, which you can switch off, of course, if you don't like it. But in this particular mode, this is the sound that you get. Sounds like an very old moped or a scooter, and reminds me of the old kinetic Honda. And this personally is my favorite mood, because it does make the perfect sound of a gearless scooter. Now, besides this, there are two more modes. So you just long press and you can switch into this menu. You can move to the Eclipse mode. Eclipse mode was the default mode that you used to get with the Ola scooters before. And this is the welcome screen, and this is how it looks like. So this, most Ola users will be familiar with this. And this is what it sounds like. So it sounds like an alien spaceship. And to switch again, we can go to the Bolt mode, which is again a new one. It has a more of a video gamey vibe to it. But my favorite remains the vintage mode. Now, so this is the mode. Here you can also set the look of the mode. So now it has been set to auto. We'll wait for, so that's the welcome. And you can also set the display. Let me turn the sound off. Now you can also set the display to adapt to the light. So this is an auto, so if it's daylight, it will be in the light mode, and if it's night, it will go to the dark mode. But if you wish to keep it in certain mode, so this is you can set it to just the day mode, or you can set it to night mode, which looks like this. You can set it to auto so that it keeps switching as and when the daylight changes. So those were the moods, which is one very important update of the MoveOS 3.0. Now let's get into the settings and show you some more goodies. Now, in terms of the setting screen right here, you will now get the battery status. You will also get the range that is available in each of the riding modes so that you can ride accordingly. It will give you the current riding stats, and also the customer service helpline number is mentioned right here. In sound settings, you obviously had the media volume before. In here, you also have a system sounds control. This one is the new control for mood sounds. So the moods that we just saw, you can control the volume of the moods using this toggle control right here. Now, in terms of lights, you now have the hazard light feature. So the Ola calls it safety lights. And if you turn it on, you will see that the hazard lights are now blinking. Also, you have the headlamp controls here, the halo lamp, so you can automatically turn on the halo lamp every time the scooter is unlocked. So you can turn on this feature. The halo lamp is the DRL on the scooter. So those were the lights. Now let's move on to the new riding mode. Now this is something new. You had regenerative braking on the Ola S1 Pro before, but you could not control the intensity of it. With this new feature, you can now control the intensity of the regen. So you can set it to low, wherein the braking is very marginal and the regen is also minimal. Default, it will apply the brakes a little harder, but it's not very intrusive and you will get a lot more regen than the low mode. And in high, the braking will be quite intrusive, so it almost comes to a standstill within a few seconds and you will get the maximum regeneration in that. Besides that, you have this new feature called Hill Hold Assist, and what this essentially does is prevents a scooter from moving backwards when you're riding uphill. So what it does is you need to when you're going uphill, you ride the scooter up a hill or on a slope, and when you hit the brakes and you leave them again, the scooter will hold its position. It will not roll back down. A very good feature, will be very helpful in assisting your riding and making your riding much more easier on the slopes. Now the hill hold works for 3 seconds and you will hear a beep like you just heard right now, and then it will go off the hill hold mode. Also, to disengage it manually, you just hit the throttle and the scooter will start getting a move on. So that was the new riding assistance in the form of hill hold assist. The battery now gets something called as the vacation mode, and once you turn this on, you need to lock the scooter. And what this essentially does, so like let's say you are going on a long vacation, you're not going to be in the city and you're not going to be using the scooter for a long time, or maybe in the monsoons you like to not use a two-wheeler, you just park it in your garage, cover it up and keep it, and then you start using it only when the rains go away. What you can do is you can put the scooter in vacation mode, and what will happen in that mode is the battery drain will be very, very limited. So the scooter goes on sleep mode, and your app will also tell you that the Ola S1 Pro is asleep, which means it's in a sleep mode and it conserves the battery. The battery drain is very, very minimal while it's on vacation mode. So that's the vacation mode. So very important. So whenever you are going on a long vacation or you're not going to use a scooter for a long duration, put it in vacation mode and conserve the battery. It also extends the battery life and it's good for the battery's overall health. Now you also have this new feature too, where you can have all the documents on the Ola screen itself. So, but you need to use the companion app with this, and you can upload your driver's license, the original documents of the scooter's ownership, or any other documents that you would need while riding. You can just upload them via the app and everything can be accessed right here with the touch of a screen. So you don't need to take your phone out, you don't need to take your wallet out to show the valid documents. And here you have the system updates button as well, wherein, like you can see, we have the Move OS 3 installed and automatic downloads are up already. So those are all the access features of the scooter. Now let's talk about the performance features and what's new and what's different with the Move OS 3.0. Now the Ola S1 Pro does get an integrated SIM card, and that's what is used to get all the over-the-air updates. However, if you want to download the software quicker and you have access to Wi-Fi, so if you are on the ground floor or maybe the first floor, you can still get Wi-Fi access to your parking lot, you can now get that as well. So to update the scooter, it becomes much more faster and easier using Wi-Fi. Bluetooth had the music controls for you, the music access. You could play music with your phone, but now you can also activate Bluetooth calling, wherein you get notified of your incoming calls and you can also answer calls while you are on the go. Now, this sound will come out from the speakers, so you have to be mindful of your conversation so that people around you do not hear of your conversations. You can speak directly. The onboard mics will pick up your voice and also a lot of background sound. So not advisable, but if there is something really, really urgent, you can just quickly answer the call, or maybe you can tell them that you are riding and you'll call back. For that purposes, this is very, very convenient. It's not very practical, but it does come in handy in terms of emergencies. You also get this reject call with an SMS. So whenever your phone is connected to the scooter and you reject a call using the onboard button, it will send a message which says, hey, I'm riding my Ola scooter, I'll call you back later. Which means that the caller will get notified that you're riding and it's not safe for you to answer the calls. And it is a very smart feature. And besides that, you can also access controls with the Ola Electric app. So this is the Ola Electric app, and right on the app you can see the range that is available. You can also open and close the boot. You can also lock and unlock the scooter. You can pair your media controls, and you can also find your nearest hyperchargers. I'll come to the hypercharging point later. Besides that, you also have this new feature called proximity unlock. So you can use your phone, and I'll show you what it works like. So you can just begin calibration here. So you need to be within 4 feet of the scooter, and then you can start the calibration. My phone is already connected, paired with the scooter. Stand behind the scooter. Now it's asking me to stand behind the scooter, so I'll just put it on the stand, go behind, and hit the button. It's asking me to move to the left. And we are done. Now I have a whole lot of options that I can use with the phone. It has proximity unlock, silent proximity unlock, where it will not make a sound, and it will also give proximity lock. So as I walk away from the scooter will lock automatically. So I'll just turn these two on and apply, and we'll see how it works. So just make sure that the handle is in lock position. It's not locked now, but it has to be in this position. And I'll just switch it off and I'll walk away, and let's see if the scooter locks. So as you saw, the scooter has now been locked. Now I'll walk towards the scooter and see if it unlocks. So I just have my phone in my hand. You can have it in your pocket as well. And I come closer to the scooter and I switch the handle, and it has unlocked itself. So that's a convenient feature. So you don't need to take the phone out of the pocket, you don't need to enter the passcode, and you can easily access the scooter and just ride away. Another nifty trick that this scooter has is a party mode, wherein you can just park your scooter, start some music, play some music, and the lights start blinking as per the music that you're playing. Now obviously it's daylight right now, I cannot show you. Obviously it's not a very functional use, but you do have something different that you can boast about. And that maybe that's what Ola is trying to sell you on. But yes, it is a different kind of trick, something that you can show off to your friends. Now besides that, a very important and useful trick that the scooter gets is the access to the hypercharge network. Now Ola has their own network of chargers, and they call it the hypercharge. Now the previous scooters were not able to fast charge. You just have to connect them to a normal 15 amp socket and you could charge the scooter. But now you can access the hypercharge network, and using the network you can fast charge the scooter and get a range of 50 kilometers in just 15 minutes of charging. Which means that you can get to go to a full charge about an hour or 15 minutes. You can go from 0 to 100% charge. Now usually that would take about 6 to 7 hours with a home charger. So access of the hypercharger will make it much more convenient for you to charge the scooter faster, and you could also go longer distances in a short period of time. So that definitely is a great added advantage. Now with the Move OS 3, Ola has given a lot of features to the new Ola S1 Pro. Now with all of these features, you can safely say that the scooter is now equipped with all the features that it needs. And in my opinion, these features should have been in the introductory Ola S1 Pro, the region modes and the hypercharging network access. Those are very important features. But Ola has already completed 1 year of manufacturing of the Ola S1 and the S1 Pro, and they have about 100,000 scooters already on the road. And after that, I can say that they have a lot of data that they have analyzed, and which has helped them to, you know, get all the features to the Ola S1 Pro as of now. And with the new update, it is much more desirable and it is much more easy to recommend. And I can say that now it stands toe-to-toe with the Ather 450X Gen 3. So if you are in the market for an electric scooter, you can definitely consider the Ola S1 Pro. And the best part is you don't have to pay anything extra for all of these new features. And when the next set of new features, the next set of update comes, it is going to come to your scooter as well. And all that happens over the air, which is really, really nice. So the Move OS 3.0 is a big step up for the Ola S1 Pro, and this scooter now makes a lot of sense. Thank you so much for watching this video, and if you have any questions about the Ola S1 Pro and the Move OS 3.0, let us know in the comments. We will try and answer each and every one of them for you. Also, if you found value in this video, you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe to Motorrads if you haven't already, and press that bell icon so that you get notified whenever we upload our next video. This is Vipul signing off. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, rev hard, rev free, and ride safe.